just trade up.
Whatever, that's more. I see your channel is growing, eh?
Guys, look how the place, this is Fairview Hotel. Look how the place is and look how Oremaya and Trudy looks. To Maya. You guys look amazing, like the location of the place.
Oremaya,
can you step back just
We try, okay.
Oremaya looks stunning with the flip-flops.
Yeah, the brand.
Trudy, why haven't you changed to Oremaya from flip-flops?
I feel like that's just him. You know, he's a simple guy. He loves to just be simple, and I have accepted him the way he is. And Africa should as well.
Yeah. I think they have. He does interviews with CEOs with the like a simple village boy.
Exactly.
You have to represent your village people. You know, like there's so many people who are born and raised in the village that never get the chance to maybe be where I am. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But they can see me and they're like, this is one of our own. If he can do this, I can do it too. So I just want my life to inspire people. So people are saying, stop wearing, you have to wear suits when you're interviewing CEOs. No.
It's a cliche.
That's not me.
It's a cliche, right?
No, that's not me. I just want to be myself so that my people will know that, hey, that's our own. And we can do it too. That's it.
It's a great one.
Yeah.
You must be proud of your boy.
Most definitely, always.
Thank you.
Hello,
what's up, bro?
Hi, how are you?
How are you, man?
Thank you.
Welcome to Africa.
Let me just smile for the camera.
Hello. You know, I'm trying to recognize this is Bo.
Yeah.
I'm finding it very hard.
She has braids.
Look at those contours.
Yeah. She's gonna cry tonight.
I have my hair done.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, so
how are you?
Follow the cameras too, guys.
But you look good.
Yeah. Thank you.
These ladies are looking good.
Yeah.
I know me mna choma.
He's saying like.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Boy,
hey.
You're looking great.
Finally, I missed
you. You've been watching her?
Yes, also thank my mom.
Your mom too?
My no mom. Way. Mama, she is a big fan of Miss Tootie.
No
really?
Oh,
yes.
Girl, I love her
I
so
think
much.
I need some photo with you.
Well, yeah. And these two big brothers, man. So you guys, what do you get to say?
My mom say first thank you for like coming up with this idea.
Yeah.
It was totally your idea.
Uh-huh.
For those guys who follow me, man, support our brother here. You know, very hardworking guy. And a guy who wanna see Africa together.
Yeah.
And we've talked our issues. We love the fact that everybody was honest and everybody's perspective was listened to.
Yeah.
And now we feel great going home like this, you know, feeling much rejuvenated. We feel more of a family than the way we came here.
Thank you, bro.
Yes,
thank
man.
You, bro.
Yeah.
I am.
I mean, like I said, whatever I was hearing, I wanted to meet him in person.
Yeah.
And then he tells me in front of me. And then, yeah, we just sorted out. Because personally, I'm a free spirit person, just moving in and out.
Yeah.
So I've met Mara, everything is okay. Yeah. Basically, nothing really happened. It was just miscommunication. So those of you out there, just show I met him. Everything is okay.
This is a big brother.
Like,
man.
When I came to Nairobi, I just called John.
Yeah.
Show me where Mara is, because I need to speak to him.
John is African traveler.
Exactly.
Yeah. The guy right there.
Here, guys.
Me, I hardly call him African traveler.
Yeah.
And the girls are having a girl talk there.
Man, this is it's my pleasure that you guys are really have ironed out your issues.
Yeah.
And life has to go on, and the movement. For me, it's My happiness is to see you guys promote the continent. No matter where you are, even if you are in a different continent, you know, you're still taking our narrative. And bro, you're also still doing a great job.
Yeah.
Welcome to Nairobi. You're in Maro. In Maro's
country.
Country. You can kill you now.
No.
come to Kenya, man.
No. Because I have Kenyans that are like brothers to me. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So he can't joke with me. I can even let him get arrested in his own country. Did you see the Kenyans that were like, I love Maya like mango.
Yeah.
I am the mayor.
he's the governor. He's the governor.
He's interviewing me. he's an interview with me, eh? Okay.
So what's your plan for Africa, man?
For me, my plan for Africa, it's huge, man. Because I'm just telling people that I'm not just a YouTuber. I'm here for a purpose.
Yeah.
I mean, I want to make an impact. So first thing, like I said it on John's video, it was the first day that I said it, like, I'm trying to build a village where, I mean, homeless people can get a place to stay, you know? So it's something that we want to do on the entire country, but basically in the village.
So
you make videos in the city, make money, take the money together, put it in the village, in the village to support communities.
I have an agenda with the community, but I think I'm not yet so ready for it.
No, but you have the, like, you see, what I found out is that sometimes I'm so scared to ask my audience to give me a dollar.
Yeah.
So scared. But let me tell you, my drone lost.
Yeah.
It entered into water.
Yeah.
And then even though I fixed the drone, I've received 5 drones.
Oh, from people. Yeah, me too. I lost my drone in Costa Rica.
And it's my
subscriber bought a new drone and sent it to me. Like it was,
like a new drone.
It's my first time talking about it.
Within a week.
Yeah. Whoa.
So now I'm like, I have 5. I just spoke about it. Even I told my PA, don't respond.
Like,
almost 100 people, everybody want to buy a drone for me.
Mm-hmm.
So my PA is like, Maya, why you don't allow me to? So just replied to some people, 5 drones yesterday.
Whoa.
So I'm like.
And you're like, if this is a drone now.
Why, if this is a drone,
why can't everyone
then
a dollar, give you a dollar?
So let's say
to help
I have
500,000
people, a dollar. $500,000.
Some YouTubers, not YouTubers, some followers feel kinda we beg for money.
Mm-hmm.
Like me, actually, I like asking people to support the channel.
Yeah.
But you'll find some people always saying, you ask money for in the internet, you're a beggar and this. Mm-hmm. But it's the same thing actually even when we do YouTube videos.
Mm-hmm.
People think we are lost and like we are crazy guys, you know. So I hope our followers try to understand us when you tell them support.
You know, like people don't understand how, what goes through behind the scene.
Mm-hmm.
They only see a final product. But personally, like, I always want to work and let my work speak for me. So I don't know, like, if something I can't say it on camera, I'll say it off camera, but I have people that every month they will just say, oh, what am I? I'm gonna send you money for this, money for that, money for that, money for that. And I just want to take all those monies and then use it for something else, because I don't need anything. All I need is a place that I'll lay my head. My mom is okay, how to move around. But now people are telling me, you need to, you know, you need to make business out of this. So that's what I was telling you. Like, I'm trying my best, you know, because when you go to an African and tell them that I want to do this for you without charging them anything, they feel like,
yeah, but you know, like, the American culture is very different.
Mm.
For Americans, they support you through donations or in any way they can.
Yeah.
But an African culture, for example, for politicians in America, people donate to the politician who they like the most. So the more people donate to you, it means people like you the most, and it will help you to finance your campaigns. But you see, if you come to Africa, it's totally the opposite. The politician gives you money, expecting you to give him the vote. So. And being on the internet, we have different types of audiences. So Americans want to support us or they want to donate, but somebody in Africa sees like we are begging for money or something like that.
Yeah, that's what I always don't like. For me, I don't even talk about it. I would just be there.
Yeah.
If it donates, thank you. Because sometimes I feel like, okay, I can't, I'll be the same as the guy on the street.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
I don't, okay, maybe, because of how I was, like, let's say, oh, give me $10, $20.
I think that's how Africans see it.
Yeah.
But in the US, guys are very open.
Yeah, I'll
like,
be like...
Africans, like, someone can be dying in the street.
Exactly.
Someone can be dying in the street and you can't say a thing.
Yes.
Like, people people are scared.
Exactly.
But like,
Americans, you'll see a girl, like, even a girl, stopping and saying, no, this is strong, and she will be like, you know.
But you know, the other thing, even Africans, to get a dime from them,
it's hard.
You will.
I just go all out. Yeah. You see, like my patron, I never talk about it. It's there. If you click on it, do you know I have consultancy?
Yeah.
Even tonight, I have somebody who has to talk to me. But the thing is, like, it's there. I don't talk about it. And when they see the link, they click, I want to speak to one of mine. And it's like $100 to speak to me for 1 hour. And every day I'm booked.
Whoa.
So this is how, like, right now I was telling Trudy, like, okay, Airbnb, like, I live free life. I don't know how to explain. So I always wanna, the one that I have, I give it up. Because there's some people that they thought I was fake when I started promoting African businesses. They said I'm fake, you go to rich people who have made it. These rich people started like me.
Yeah.
You know, so I feel like Africans don't believe that Africans can make it in life.
No, I think most Africans are really colonized. And they have like to hit you with a knife from the back. That's most of them like that type of businesses. They don't see flourishing, you
flourish,
know.
It's,
you know, like in the village, let's say you wanna build a big house, even you're scared to build a big house in your village. You wanna build it in town where nobody knows you. So you see, that's an African thing.
Mm.
But you travel, like me, I've been to 36 countries, big cities like San Francisco, you know, Miami. Man, people live, man. So that's the same thing I'm trying to say. Here in Africa, we have to see ourselves very differently. It's only in Africa, when you are a black YouTuber, you are a terrorist. But if he's white, he's a tourist, you know? So you see things like that. Or, for example, filming in big cities is a crime.
Yeah, like in Nairobi.
Like Nairobi.
I have been arrested, deported so many times because I'm filming in Africa. But what I'm telling you is like...
So that's a mentality, you see.
Something that we have against ourselves, you know?
Yeah, that's a mentality.
You know, like when I started filming this business guys, man, I got a lot of people saying, stop lying to them. This guy stole, he's a politician, he stole the money. And I'm like, I met a guy who had nothing.
Yeah.
Started from scratch. You come, who is? Why are you guys envying the person? You know, stories like this are meant to inspire other people to go for it.
And that's what you're saying.
But this is what people are telling me. I'm fake. I'm collecting money from these people.
No,
the internet is like a heat place. People don't know you, but they think
in my videos of posh estate in Nairobi, when you see comments, it's always like those are thieves, they are politicians, and the sort. You know, it's guys don't believe someone can work hard.
Yeah,
they don't believe that Africans can make it in their own continent.
Yes, they are so negative.
It's like we as Africans, that's what I'm saying. Like, I used to promote resorts, then I'll go and check it out. The resort is owned by an African,
most of the resorts.
So why am I supposed to promote it? So now I go to a resort that is owned by, I have nothing against anybody, but I just feel like people are looking down upon Africans. So I just see anything that is owned by Africans.
People don't believe like you as an African. You deserve the best.
Exactly.
You deserve the best of the best.
And it's not
like,
even people. It's
and if you
people.
Get it, you're not right.
Something.
Yeah.
You know? And that's the same thing happening in Nigeria, for example.
If you get young, you're Yahoo, you're cyber crime.
And you see, that's a mentality that keeps us always low. Mm-hmm. Even when you're a kid, when you're growing up, your mom tells you, do you know how life is hard? You're playing with this maybe 10 these CDs or shillings or dollars. So they kind of put you in a situation where even you don't believe in yourself, you can't see dreams.
Yeah,
and you go to other countries where kids are given everything. They are told you can be whatever you want to be, you know.
Yeah, but I'm telling Africans that it's time.
Yeah.
And the time is now.
Yeah.
I don't care whether people hate me or not. I'm not going to stop promoting African businesses. I'm not racist. But I've lived in a country where people look down upon me.
Yeah.
So I come to my country, I need to brag about what my people are doing.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I was doing videos for these people without even collecting a dollar. I came to Kenya, I filmed my first video. I met a guy in Ghana, he's married to a Kenyan.
Yeah.
You can ask him, I didn't even collect a dollar. I had to ask my subscribers, do you think I need to charge? Because this kind of videos that I'm doing, it takes the whole day.
Yeah.
So it takes the whole day, you have to give him something, you know? It does all this.
And you travel around the world. What is your advice to Africans like that?
Young Africans, man, don't listen to your parents. I feel like sometimes our parents are our major problems.
Mm-hmm.
Because them, they don't want to see the life like we young people yearn to see. They're always telling you maybe, let's say you're a musician, they see you like you're crazy, you're out of control, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I
remember. You're a YouTuber.
Yeah, you're a YouTuber, you're lost.
He was an engineer, you know? He changed career.
I feel like sometimes our parents are one of our major hindering, like, they have been in some state of life,
mm-hmm.
and we people, we always connect with people. We see people in Germany what they are doing, people in the US what they are, we want to be like them,
mm.
but the mentality still is very bad here,
yeah.
and like a guy like me, actually I refuse to that type of mentality, yeah. up to today. You know, we are still like, man, we're gonna keep shining no matter what. Yeah, if you're young there, come out, you're a musician, you're a guitar, man, learn some skill that can push you or can take you to the next level. Even if that certificate is not working, you finished your master's or degree and you don't have any work, a skill will save your life. That's all I have to say.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Really appreciate you guys. And Africa United,
yeah, man.
Shall never be defeated, man.
It's all good, bro.
It's all good.
All right.
Thank you.
John.